discovering and replacing sections of your code with a new Java language feature, even if you do not know the feature name or its syntax, such as replacing an if-else block with switch, or converting a record to a regular class when you are moving to a Java version that doesn't support records. Removing redundant code, such as a final method in a record, which is implicitly final, or a redundant close method, or a method that declares to throw an exception which is never thrown in the method body. Finding and fixing parts of your code which are probable bugs, using the correct pattern to instantiate simple date format instance. Deleting the line of code where a collection class like an ArrayList adds it to itself. Preferring the usage of parameterized types over raw types. And using the equals method to compare value of string instances, adding code to a while loop which doesn't define any code. These were just a few examples. There are many more ways, languages and frameworks in which IntelliJ IDEA can analyze your code and suggest improvements and fixes. In this video, I'll cover how to get started with code analysis. Is it always on or do you need to initiate it? Inspections versus intentions. The difference between analyzing your code with inspections and applying the fixes using intentions. How to view all the available inspections and intentions and to customize them. I'll also cover how to create new profiles so that you can analyze your code for specific inspections and how to create new inspections. By default, both code inspections and intentions are on, which means that IntelliJ IDEA will analyze your code and suggest ways to improve it as you write your code. Depending on the color scheme that you use for your editor, these can be shown with a yellow background, gray text, or underlined using a red squiggly line, and others. You can also view the results of code inspections and intentions by moving your cursor on the horizontal bars on the right side of your editor. In the highlighted example, the condition on the left-hand side is the result of a code inspection, and the suggestion to improve this code is the result of code intention. You can check out the other bars and see the code inspections and intentions. As an alternate, you can view all these in the problems view window by either clicking on this widget in the top right corner of your editor window or by using the shortcut Alt-6. In this window, you can navigate the problem code, analyze it, and also apply the suggestions by IntelliJ IDEA. For example, the inspection explicit type argument label can be replaced with the diamond operator, has a quick fix which can be invoked by using Alt and Enter and then using the Enter key to implement it. Similarly, I could use the quick fix for this problem code by replacing the anonymous comparator with a lambda. This could result in introduction of other errors like the unused import statement, which again I can fix by using the suggestions by IntelliJ IDEA. The next problem states that the variable amount might not have been initialized. The suggestion is to initialize the variable amount to a value, but this will not work because I have defined the variable amount as a final local variable. When I revisit the getAmount method, I realize that the variable amount is assigned a value when the code equals Roman 1 or Roman 2 value, and not if any other values is passed to this method. So an alternate could be to define an else block here. Now if I go back to my problems window, fix for this problem is that it can be replaced with num equal to 3. We can also work with all the problems across the code base by clicking on project errors and enabling the project-wide analysis. Here, no errors have been found by the IDE, and the two options that we have are to build the project or to inspect code. Let me click on inspect code and select the scope as the whole project. There are other custom scopes available as you can view here. And the profile as the project default. Later in this video, I'll also talk about creating a custom profile for your inspections. Now, when I click on the Analyze button, I would see a list of the problems with my code base, which has been grouped under different categories. Issues with HTML files, JVM languages, Java, which again has multiple groupings, which is abstraction issues, class structure, code style issues, and many others. I could also change how I want these groupings. Now let me go back to directory, and here I can expand these and select whether I want to accept these changes or not. There are a lot of problems with the declaration redundancy that I can see here. Java language migration level issues, probable bugs, Java doc, blank line can be ignored. That makes sense. Does the project errors make you wonder? How many inspections and intentions are there, and is there a way to browse through all of them? Access settings and search for inspections. You'll be able to see multiple inspections for various languages or frameworks like Android, Angular, Gradle, Groovy, Hibernate, Java, and many more. Each of these group has a box next to it. A check sign indicates that all the inspections in this category have been enabled. A missing check or any other mark indicates that all inspections have been disabled. And a minus sign indicates that some of the inspections are enabled and some are disabled, which also means that not all the inspections are enabled by default. You can enable or disable inspections as they are applicable to your project. Let's modify an existing inspection, say redundant record constructor, by changing its severity. Records is a new language feature, and I want the team members on this project to use its constructor properly and not make it redundant. And instead of assigning an existing severity, I can define a new one with the name, say, incorrect record constructor, and choose a custom background color. Now I can execute inspect code again and see how the customization of this inspection looks. And let IntelliJ IDEA analyze the code base for me. I can choose to display the categories by severity and look for the custom severity that I created. This is how you can customize inspections and see their results when you inspect your code base. When you inspect your code base, you might want to run a specific set of inspections, say to find problems that are related to migrating your code to a newer Java version. Is that possible? Yes, it is. You can do so by creating a new inspection profile. Go to Settings, Inspections, click on the Settings icon, select Duplicate, and change the profile name to, say, Migrate to Java 21. Now select the inspections you want to include in this profile. Since I want to add just a handful of inspections to the profile, I start with none by clicking on Reset to Empty. Then I can scroll to the set of inspections I want to include in this profile. Use Find action to execute inspect code and select the newly created profile Migrate to Java 21 in the inspection profile. When you click on the Analyze button, the results are specific to code analysis and suggestions that are specific to code migration to newer Java version. Imagine you want to analyze your code and find out methods or constructors which accept more than, let's say, 5 method parameters, because it's a code smell and such methods should be called out. Is it possible to create a new inspection to do so? Yes, it is. Go to Settings, Inspections, click on Add New Inspection, and then select the type of inspection. For this example, we'll keep it simple and select Add Structural Search Inspection. If you are interested in finding out more about structural search and replace, check out the link to a relevant video in the description. Instead of creating a new inspection from scratch, one of the quickest way is to duplicate an existing inspection and modify it. Since for this inspection, we are looking at something that can work with constructors and methods, look for these words in the list of existing inspections, constructors and methods. Examine its definition and modify the minimum value of the count of the method parameters passed to it as 5. Now let's change the inspection name. Add a tooltip that shows in the editor. Click on OK. You can also execute a single inspection by using the command run inspection by name and view its results. In this video, I covered the importance of code inspections and how you can analyze your code and apply fixes and improvements via intentions. This is a short video and I did not include all the scenarios in which you could use code inspections. I covered how to get started with analyzing your code, applying fixes, viewing all the inspections, customizing them, including creation of new inspections and inspection profiles. I hope this video helps you to analyze your existing code and develop better code in the future. Let me know your feedback by commenting on this video. And thanks for watching.